Load2Learn, making curriculum materials accessible.
Hello, welcome to this Load2Learn video on how to turn any PDF into a worksheet with a free PDF XChange viewer. In this video, we will have a look at why you may want to use a PDF document as a worksheet, how to use a PDF document as a worksheet, and how to get and configure PDF XChange viewer to help you do that. Now, we all know that text inside a PDF cannot be changed, and that's often perceived as one of the downsides of PDFs. But in fact, that is what PDFs were designed for. They are a version of the paper printed document that also cannot be changed, but in electronic form. But often, you want your students to complete a worksheet that you send them in a PDF format without having to print it out first. But how do you do that when a PDF is not editable? For example, you may have a worksheet with some fill in the blanks, some circling and matching, the sort of things that is often used in schools. And you may want the student to submit that something that looks like this, with your name, some matching, and some circling. But again, as we said, this cannot be done in the standard PDF reader, which is Adobe Reader. But if you install a free tool that works on Windows called PDF XChange Viewer, you can do all of that. This is how you do it. For example, if you want to fill in a blank in a PDF worksheet, PDF XChange Viewer has a tool called Typewriter. You simply click on Typewriter and then click inside the PDF and start typing. Or you can use the strike through tool. So you select a bit of text and strike it out so it looks like it's crossed out. Or you can draw arrows between words to match them or other items to match. Or you can circle things very easily by using the circle tool. This all takes no time at all, and it really is just a matter of clicking and drawing, something that students are very comfortable with. This is incredibly easy to do, and imagine how much effort and frustration this could save. You can simply email your students a PDF, they complete it like this, and then you use a different color to make your comments and send it back to them. The savings on paper alone are certainly worth the investment in time in learning how to use this tool. So the first thing you need to do is install PDF XChange Viewer on your computer. And the best way when you find out about any new software is to simply put it into a search engine like Google and search for it. And then you'll generally find the first results, or one of the top results will be the one that you need. So then we go to the PDF XChange webpage and then download and install the software. There are multiple options on this particular website, and you can choose how to download a PDF XChange Viewer in many formats. The one that you most often want on your home computer is the EXE installer. That's the one you simply double click and it installs. But you may also want to use the portable installer, which means that you can copy all the files onto a USB key and then carry it around with you. So it works on any PC that you can plug in a USB key into. Once you have installed PDF XChange Viewer, you need to configure it so that it works exactly the way you want. So by default, you don't see any of the tools I showed you earlier. You simply see something that looks like this. So you need to go to the View menu and Toolbars menu and choose the Comment and Markup toolbar. And you also want to choose the Properties toolbar. Once you have done that, a new toolbar will appear. And then if you choose any of the options on it, such as Typewriter, a sub-toolbar will appear where you can set the options. So for example, the default color and font that the Typewriter tool uses may not be the one you want. So you simply type something and then choose the right font and color for your writing that you want and click on the Make Default button. And that way, every time you use the Typewriter tool from now on, the text will automatically appear in the right font and color. It is also worth knowing that you can not only add toolbars, but you can also take some away. So you may get rid of the Find toolbar, Rotate View toolbar, and some of the other ones, so that you have a bit less on the screen and you just have the key toolbars that you want. Most of the ones that you will want are the one with the Comment and Markup tools. And you can also drag them around and arrange them on the screen to suit you. So now that you have installed PDF XChange Viewer, every time you run it, you will be asked if you wanted to make the default PDF viewer. And whether you want to do this or not depends on how you use PDFs. As we already discussed, the default PDF viewer on your computer is probably Adobe Reader. And Adobe Reader does not have all these annotation features. However, it does have some accessibility features that you can learn about in other videos. And you may or may not be using those features, so if you are using those features, you do not want to make PDF XChange viewer your default PDF viewer. But if you are not, you can go ahead and make it your default viewer. You can always change that option later. If you choose not to make PDF XChange viewer the default, all that means that every time you want to open a worksheet to fill it out with PDF XChange viewer, instead of double-clicking on it, you right-click, choose the Open With option, and choose PDF XChange Viewer to open the document with. Very simple. Just to help you make that decision, the key features that are missing in PDF XChange Viewer that are useful for accessibility is no text-to-speech that's built in, and also it does not allow you to reflow text. But of course, the Adobe Reader has the downside of having limited annotations, and also it cannot be made portable, which means that if you come to a computer where it is not installed, you cannot have it on a USB key and run it from that. Finally, here is a bonus tip for what you can do with PDF XChange Viewer. If you have made a lot of comments on a student's work, then you can choose some useful options, for example, summarize comments, that will print the comments on a separate page and link them to the comments on the document. This feature is only available in the commercial version of PDF XChange Viewer, but the PDF XChange Viewer that you've downloaded for free has a demonstration version that will work, except it will put a PDF XChange Viewer logo in the corners to remind you that you should purchase the commercial version if you want to use this feature. If you would like a reminder of some of these features without having to watch this video again, you can go and download the Computer Productivity and Accessibility cue cards. And one of the cue cards is referring to how to use PDF XChange Viewer. You can also find many other tips on how to use your computer more productively and accessibly in the cue cards. And you can print them out for free from the Load2Learn website. Thank you for watching.
Thank you for watching. For more tutorials or information about Load2Learn, please visit loadtolearn.org.uk or contact us on 0300 303 8313. Copyright 2012 Dyslexia Action and R&IB. Licensed under the Creative Commons license by attribution for non-commercial purposes and shared alike.